if you're a guy over 50 and you've got 15, 20 pounds that you want to lose so you can look in shape for summer, at least be able to take that top off without it looking like another solar eclipse on that beach, I've got a 5-step easy plan for you. Always works, rain or shine. Now, obviously, if you've got more than 15, 20 pounds to lose and you want disgusting results like this, you need to book a call with me. Now, let's get back to this losing 15, 20 pounds and building just that little bit of muscle. Let's get that customary, who am I, out of the way. I'm Simon H, the naturally jacked 53-year-old, and I've been helping guys just like you lose fat, build muscle for a minute now. Now, let's shift that out of the way, because step number one is going to drive your success. We need to calculate your calories and your protein. Let's start with calories first. Now, I want you, shut your eyes, pick a realistic goal, and I mean realistic goal weight. Got that in pounds? Now, times it by 12, give or take 100 calories either way, and we're looking to average that over time. Now, I'm not looking for perfection. I'm looking at you poking that consistency. Now we got that, let's calculate our protein. And while there are other methods that I much prefer to use, for the sake of simplicity and this video, I want you to shoot for 0.7 grams per pound to 1 gram per pound of body weight. Got that? Okay. The leaner you are, the closer to 1 gram per pound of body weight you need to be. Before we jump off the protein, let me give you some protein tips. Whole eggs, much better than egg whites. Yeah, you've got your chicken, you've got your turkey, your beef, but have you got your oily fish, such as your salmon? Wild caught is better, and your mackerel. Now here comes two curveballs, and before you turn up your nose, let me tell you, they're the most nutritional dense proteins on the planet Earth, and that is beef liver, calf liver slightly better, and beef heart. Do some research. Now, don't obsess over your fats, but you're gonna need some in your diet. And I would go for your egg yolks, your oily fish, coconut oil, and walnuts. You know why they're shaped like a brain, don't you? Fill the rest of your calories with carbs. And I mean good carbs, such as sweet potatoes, wild rice, oats if you need. And make sure you've got some green veg on that plate. Green veg are super important when it comes to stacking that potassium. Super important when it comes to alkalizing that body and making sure you keep a balanced pH system. Number two, or step two, should I say, it's all about the fiber. Because it ain't moving, you ain't losing. Now you need to be shooting for about 25 grams of fiber per day. Now you can get that from strawberries, raspberries, oats, wild rice, chia seeds, beans, you get the picture. Number three, I want you to be focused on mindful movement. And I'm not talking about mindful movement in the gym. I'm talking about mindful movement as soon as your feet touch the ground in the morning as you're getting out of bed. So things like taking the dog for a walk, good mindful movement. Things like not being that person that finds is only focused on that car parking space nearest the grocery door. No, park at the other end of the car lot so you can get out and walk. Don't be that sucker that uses the elevator. Use the stairs in the mall. Use the stairs at work. That's what I'm calling about mindful movement. We should be aiming for 8,000 to 10,000 steps, because we've got so many body systems that can make use of this mindful movement. Plus, it's really good for that blood pressure. Keep it on the low. Okay, step number four are for the guys who are not just chasing the number on the scale, but they wanna look good. You need to be picking up some heavy shit and putting it back down again. This is where most people mess up. They spend their whole time on the treadmill, walking off the last ounces of muscle they've got. Or they're doing a resistance workout program that is not optimized for them. You're not gonna be that walking string bean that looks worse now he's lost 15 or 20 pounds. No, because you realize how important muscle is for guys after 50. It's simple. Muscle is good for longevity. Muscle is the organ of longevity. It's good for that vitality. Great to help you avoid diabetes, insulin resistance, bone health. Super important for keeping you safe as you get older. Now, if you're thinking to yourself, oh, it all sounds great, but I don't know where to start with my workout program. Plus, I don't want to be in the gym five times a week training. I've got the perfect workout program for you. Link in the description. Step number 5, it's not glamorous. None of the influencers are really talking about it, but hair up. Here it is, so underestimated. You've got to get your sleep and your stress levels in check. I swear, sleep is so important, especially for guys over 50. If you ain't sleeping, you're not repairing, and you're not growing, and you're not getting better, and your hormones are gonna be all over the place. So make sure you get the right amount of sleep. Now, if you're lost and you don't know how to fix your sleep, maybe you need to go and see a sleep doctor. Or maybe you need to go down, check my page for the 9 best sleeping tips. Now, don't be that guy who waits a month before his summer vacation to crash diet his way to losing weight only to pull it back on with interest. No, be that guy that starts now. Start now, thank me later. Subscribe, like, share, comment, and I'll be back for more tips for men over 50. Peace.